Good evening, everybody. We are really honored for acceptance of distinguished panelists in a very short period. And it is a privilege for us, many of them having long
success in
this society. I think that we need to explain about what kind of work in the area of labor, migration, and culture of the community, particularly in Bihar. In this background, 3-4 days ago, we have discussed very distinguished one of the panelists, Dr. Praveen Sinha, as well as Dr. Nikhil Nair. How can we plan out particularly the unprecedented crisis with reference to the reverse migration in Bihar? Or in this background, in fact, we are planning to hold a discussion through Google being on this critical theme. Before the hand over the moderating to the Nikhil, in fact, there are two, three points. In fact, briefly, I would like to say one, the nature of the unrest is very disturbing to come from not only a multidisciplinary background, but multi-sectoral background, academicians, policymakers, international institution, as well as a person who represents the corporate background and development practices. As for the discipline concerned, it is very exceptional, multidisciplinary background, economist, developmental practitioner, psychologist, journalist, and sociologist. As you know, particularly the theme which we are discussing now, broadly, there are many versions and statistics, but broadly, I think so that if you see the data from the Bihar government, generally in across India, around between 2 to 2.5 million labor. And there are several categories of labor that came back and returned to Bihar. If you look at the perspective from the below in Bihar, I think so. Everyone, either talked to bottom, in fact, talked about this unprecedented crisis. And the same way, when they talk about the COVID-19 as well as the crisis which is emerged from the return migration of Bihar. In this background, one thing is very important as for the public policy discourse as well as the government context. Both, I think, have a common conclusion. This is a quote on one hand, crisis, but on the other hand, this is the potentiality which we will use to take forward the agenda for the change and for the transformation of Bihar. So this background, I think, should be all of us have been received a concept note on this theme, and I hope that you might be brought over to the concept note. This concept note basically develop around the getting guidance and advice from Dr. Praveen Sinha as well as Dr. Nikhil Raj. Last week, before we will invite for the moderating panel to Dr. Nikhil Raj, in fact, there are two things. In the discussion, it's not a part of discussion, we are a bit background, but the most important thing to develop action plan at both level as a member of the so in the back, in the last time of the discussion, I think very it will be significant or in the middle of the discussion also to make a specific recommendation at both an immediate level or the short term, medium term, and the long term. Thank you so much. I will request to Nikhil kindly moderate the discussion.
Thank you, Sanjay ji, and welcome once again to our esteemed participants and panelists. This is, as Mr. Sanjay has indicated, this is one of the set of activities that Deshkal has been traditionally engaged in, and the current corona pandemic has given us this opportunity to look at some of the issues emerging out of the reverse migration that the North Indian states have seen, particularly in the Eastern India, UP, Bihar, Orissa, and parts of West Bengal. We started this discussion at the initial round of discussions with Dr. Praveen Sinha, who himself is an expert in labor issues, has worked extensively on issues of social protection, labor, and migration during his career with many international organizations, including the FES. He was a senior labor advisor there also. We benefited from his, he cajoled us literally to get into action. Thank you, Dr. Sinha. So may I now, I mean, without much ado, may I request Dr. Praveen Sinha to set the context for this and why we have gathered here in a small group and I specifically request Dr. Sinha to highlight the broad context, and then we can move on to the other guests and panelists whom we have invited. It is a very, very focused group, and we want to arrive at some next way forwards and the road ahead beyond this meeting. Thank you, Dr. Sinha. Over to you.
Thank you, Nikhil. Thank you, Sanjay ji. और बाकी सबों को, मेरा नाम प्रवीण सिन्हा है. इन्होंने इंट्रोडक्शन तो बहुत बड़ा दिया, बट आई एम प्राइमरली अ फंक्शनरी. और हाँ, मैंने काफी साल काम किया इन द एरिया ऑफ लेबर, एंड मेरा क्लोज एसोसिएशन रहा है विद देशकार फॉर क्वाइट सम टाइम. यू कैन हियर मी? आवाज आ रही है?
Yes.
क्लियर? So, yes, I have worked with Deshkal also for quite some time. And the idea for this this short consultation came in the background of a concept note that was developed by Deshkal Society. Aur concept note ka background tha, jo pichle 3-4 mahino mein, what we have seen on the electronic and print media with regard to conditions of migrant worker who are faced with a situation where in fact many a time you find that they are left without any effective support from the system, from the government, in spite of the fact that there has been a lot of announcement with regard to what they should receive and how they should receive. How and why we as a desh part of Deshkal become concerned is that majority of these workers were from Bihar and UP. Of course, they were from southern part of the country also, but primarily from Bihar, UP, Jharkhand, Assam, and to some extent northeast also. But major chunk came from Bihar and UP. And majority of them were those which were working at a place in either Punjab or in Gurgaon or Goa or Maharashtra. Lekin suddenly within a fraction of 4 hours, jo government policy announcement hui, one with regard to national lockdown, and second with regard to closure of business establishment. So you find that suddenly ye jo worker hain, suddenly they lost major source of income. And then because there was no support base, they do not figure in the records of the state or central government insofar securing benefits of one or other type, because most of them are undocumented workers. They do not come under the Interstate Migration Act, because the Migration Act says something else. And as such, you find that ki ek major chunk hai jo suddenly within a fraction of 4 hours, they were left high and dry. Ek taraf se to job gayi, dusri taraf se jo any source of, any sense of security thi, agar thi, वो भी चले गए, क्योंकि पैसा नहीं है तो न मकान है, न दवाई है, न खाना है. एंड in that situation, they felt that they should go towards a place where they will feel secure, and it was, of course, they started marching towards their house. And even at that time, they were looted either by the transporter or by people or administration on the way. So by the time they reached, many of them back to their villages, they were left with nothing, no saving, only maybe a sack or bag on the head. एक बोरी सिर पे थी, उसमें बर्तन थे और खाना का कुछ होगा अब था तो. Otherwise, they had nothing. So this was the pathetic situation. और जब वो गांव पहुंचे तो वहां भी not they were really welcome, because even there we saw reports that when they reached there were certain group of people who assembled to keep them out at the border of the village, so for this so-called quarantine period of 14 days, and they were treated like an outsider. Now the situation that comes, the feeling that came, is that I think there need to be something done with regard to how these workers needs to be one, treated, second, how their livelihood is ensured, and third, how they reintegrate either in the village, or if they wish to go back to the place from jahan se wo aaye the, how do they go so that they are able to reach their place and not exploited again. So this was the whole background, we had a discussion before this concept note was made. A nice concept was made. I hope it was shared with all of you also. And then an idea came ki ye do aadmi, teen aadmi, char aadmi ki thinking hai, aur isko ek more concrete shape dene ke liye ye zaruri hai ki hum ek larger not very large but larger professional group, jo usme kaam kiye hain, those who have been active in the area, they come with a concrete proposal with regard to how we deal this the plight of migrant worker in these three specific situations, like what Sanjay said. Immediate to relief hoga, second is the medium term, and third is the long term, where what they call it, that rehabilitation. So you have initial is you have this relief, and the government has talked about even just now I was listening to the Prime Minister ki wo ek scheme hai jo November tak ke liye extend kar diya gaya hai, free anaj ka स्कीम को एक्सटेंड कर दिया गया कि फ्री अनाज मिलेगा हर परिवार को नवंबर तक का. स्कीम होना और एक्सटेंड करना एक बात है, उसकी डिलीवरी दूसरी बात है. आज 70 साल में हमने ये देखा है कि स्कीम्स बनी हैं, वी हैव अ लॉट मेनी लॉज, वी हैव लॉट मेनी स्कीम्स, लेकिन क्या बेनिफिट एक्चुअल पर्सन को मिला है या बीच में ही खाया गया है, बीच में ही गायब हो गया. एंड आई थिंक दैट इज अ कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न, नॉट दैट द स्कीम्स हैव नॉट आर नॉट अवेलेबल, नॉट दैट मनी इज नॉट अवेलेबल, द ह्यूज मनी दैट इज बीइंग सेड 19,000 करोड़, 100,000 करोड़, इट लुक्स मैमथ अमाउंट ऑफ मनी, बट व्हाट रियली रीचेस टू द रियल टारगेट पर्सन, दैट शुड बी वन कंसर्न इज व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट रिलीफ मैटर. Can we as a group suggest modality, and the focus is of course Bihar and UP state government, can we suggest a modality which is different than what bureaucrat suggests? Bureaucrats are good, but they have limitations, because the ground realities that are there with you and I as a functionary at the ground level, which somehow gets diluted or blurred when it reaches to the office of the bureaucracy. And I think Deshkal has been serving as a link between the final beneficiary or the final target population and the policy framers, policy delivers. So that is one thing I would put before you. क्या हम ऐसा कोई चीज सजेस्ट कर सकते हैं इन रिलीफ मैटर जो 500 रुपया 1000 रुपया 5000 रुपया जो भी कहा जा रहा है या अनाज की बात हो रही है वो इफेक्टिवली टारगेट पॉपुलेशन के पास पहुंचे. इट्स नॉट दैट द एफर्ट इज नॉट बीइंग मेड. I am with the trade union for quite some time. You look at the NGOs, you look at the trade union, they are delivering food in not only in Delhi, but in all parts of the country, in Bihar, in Uttar Pradesh, in West Bengal, as far as Sundarban. I have a colleague who is running this National Hawker Federation. They go by boat to deliver the food material there. So see, people are there, but coordination is a problem. I go and deliver the food, then the next boat comes, they also deliver the food there. And in the sense, what happens that one group get the higher food material, other doesn't get the same amount of money. So that is one idea I would like to put before you, that can we as a group think of a certain modality that we can suggest to the state government कि जो रिलीफ मटेरियल है इसमें क्या प्रिकॉशन लिया जाए सो दैट वी कैन रिड्यूस द लीकेज एंड डुप्लीकेशन. द सेकंड थिंग द सेकंड एजेंडा दैट आई थिंक इज बिफोर अस इज आई वाज लुकिंग एट द नोट दैट संजय जी हैज शेयर्ड एंड देयर वन सेकंड वेयर इज दैट. There he has touched upon 6 or 7 points, 8 points. Now, the first one, Sanjay talks about the skill mapping. And this is a very important database that is required because jitne bhi worker the bahar, wo सारे क्या नाम है अनस्किल्ड वर्कर नहीं थे. आइदर दे वर वर्किंग इन एग्रीकल्चर और इन द कंस्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्री और इन द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर. सबके पास कुछ ना कुछ स्किल था बट दैट स्किल इज नॉट सर्टिफाइड स्किल. दे डू नॉट पोजेस डिग्री और डिप्लोमा लाइक यू एंड आई हैव टू शो कि भाई देखिए मेरे पास ये क्वालिफिकेशन है. एंड इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ that certified qualification, they can only be employed as a manual labor, which has been the problem all these years. So skill mapping is an exercise that I think it needs to be done, which will be used at the medium and the long term, not at the immediate period, because immediate is a relief matter. In the relief matter, we need to look at all the schemes that are government relief delivery and relief scheme that are there, and whether that information is available to panchayat people, or if the panchayat is information hai to kya wo see significantly seriously distribute kare equitability to affected party, or it goes back to one or other family of the panchayat leaders. That we need to look at. We need to find a way to strengthen the capacity of the block development officers, and whether we can find some way, because block development officers, you know, the last survey we did in Gaya of Deshkal, where we were looking at this Gair Majuria land, Sanjay ji.
Yes.
There we found, there and other surveys that I did with some other local partners, we found that the block development officer or the officer at the lowest level are the most exploited, most burden person. सारी चीज के सिर पर डाल देते हैं without him or her getting any support system in so far the either help as a manual. So or proper document है तो अंग्रेजी में उसको बेचारे को समझ नहीं आता. So all these things needs to be looked at, that how the delivery system has to be looked at. Then he talks about cash transfer. Cash transfer was talked about a lot many times, and eventually 500 rupees ki baat hui thi, or three accounts ho raha hai. And you and I know what ghapla goes there. Either the bank person or the in between man. What the ghapla they do? Dene se pehle paisa or certain amount of money they already take it away. So we need to look at that one. I think the point is that well taken. Insofar payment of wages is concerned, especially in the case of manufacturing sector, jo March 29th Ministry of Home Affairs ne order pass kiya tha. Now there is some confusion with regard to that order. A confusion is that it is said, the advocate says, I'm president of National Labor Law Association also. My member says that it does not have legal standing. The Ministry of Home Affairs ordered it does not have legal standing. So it cannot be taken as a right to the workmen for the payment of wages. Furthermore, a group of companies, they have already approached Supreme Court saying that we don't have capacity to pay. And finally, the Supreme Court has said that, look, we don't take any decision. Both workers group and the employers group sit together and find a way out so that nobody is oppressed. So that is the position as of now, that employers are reluctant to pay. They said, when my business is closed, how can I pay? But this can be taken as a rightful reasoning, or this can be taken as unwillingness to support the worker who has been helping you to earn profit over the last so many years on a wages which are below minimum wages that you have been paying. So this is, I find third point is rather tricky, and there we need, if we touch upon that one, we will have to develop link between the employer in the in the state where they were working vis-a-vis the workmen. And mind you, none of the worker have the document to prove that they were employed there. They were there through either directly undocumented worker or through labor contractor, which we can't find. But that is an important topic to be looked at. And that relates to primarily of the manufacturing sector, probably the factory system, because when the Ministry of Home Affairs, when they brought out that circular, it was primarily with regard to manufacturing sector, because they said that they should be paid, which is whether they are working or not, because they will be, according to that circular, they should be treated as people on the job. Then, of course, we come to the government proposition with regard to Swabhiman, Atmanirbhar Bharat, you know, which will promote local entrepreneurs. And I fully agree with the comments that has been stated, is that not everybody is business-wise inclined. Jab mere paas khane ke liye paisa nahi hai, to business ke liye kahan se paisa hoga? And I give you example of cooperatives. When I was looking at the cooperatives, cooperatives mein kaha gaya tha ki, Pandit Nehru ka ye statement tha ki, har gaon mein cooperative develop kar jayenge. कोऑपरेटिव को स्टार्ट करना एंड कोऑपरेटिव को मेंटेन करना इज अ डिफरेंट बॉल गेम. we are looking at a section of population now who are without much saving. They don't have capital base. And agar hum, if we become intermediary with regard to securing loan from the bank, then we will face the same challenge as we faced during the LDB, Land Development Bank time. If you remember, there used to be loan for Chapakal, there used to be loan for this machine, cut and all the machine. The bank people used to eat up the money. And there used to be program for unemployment graduate scheme. All these things were there. There are flaws. There are flaws. But then I come back to the initial point is that the main basis for all these, basis for all schemes to take a shape is the development of database. Unless we have database with regard to what kind of people we are talking about, do they have any capital base, they don't have capital base, do they have paper qualification but no skill certificate. There are two things. You can have MA, you can have PhD in paper, but he doesn't have skill qualification. So that also creates problem. So we, what is the qualification status of these workers? And I'm sure, though, whether the person comes from UP or Bihar, lot many people will be graduate and postgraduate, but they are faced with a situation where they had to work as a migrant worker in water pollution. So I think I will stop here for the time being. But that was the background where we try to look at, and the idea is to come out with a proposal which we can give to both to the Bihar government and also to the state government as an instrument to see that how these migrant workers could be effectively taken care of. That we and how Deshkal can be party to the whole process of developing database, the process of developing link between the policymaker and the final beneficiary, how it can design and develop a program that could be of help to the state government insofar delivery system is concerned, because delivery is a problem. And in the case of Bihar, we are in a situation where October, November is election time. If I'm not wrong, October, November, December, there will be election time. And that is before that you have this monsoon season, both in UP and Bihar. So we are in a tight shoe. And as such, our effort will be, if it is quick, it will be taken as a positive effort by the state governments. I open the floor for all of you.
Thank you, Dr. Sinha, for giving those details and painting the broader canvas, including some of the finer details as well. I think we have some esteemed core group of people, friends, well-wishers of Deshkal Society who have agreed at such a short notice. And I would take this opportunity to call upon each one of them and request them to share their own perspectives on some of the questions that you have raised, and anything additional that those some of the questions that we as a group should mull over or need to further dive into. I welcome Mr. Arvind Mohan, who is a seasoned journalist. For me, Mr. Mohan, the last one that I remember was listening to the Run Champaran on the All India Radio. And that's how my latest learnings of Gandhi have gone into it, and all his works in Bihar around Champaran. Thank you for giving us to the Indian radio that brilliant documentary. I would recommend this to everybody whosoever has not heard it. That was a time when documented at a well broadcast at a good time when we were on our way to the office and we would listen this to in our vehicles. Over to you, Mr. Mohan. And we would आपसे हम ये समझना चाहेंगे आपके विचार में as a journalist, as a seasoned development professional, कि किस तरह से हम लोग ये इन मुद्दों को थोड़ा सा एक actionable point बनाने के लिए कोशिश कर सकते हैं. And then 5 minutes each, and then we'll move on to the next panelist, and then finally we'll come over to wrap up. Sanjay ji, we have time till 6 o'clock, right?
I think so.
Okay, good. So Arvind Mohan ji, over to you, sir. आपका माइक्रोफोन बंद है. No, we can't hear you. Nafees, can you hear him?
No.
थोड़ा उनको हेल्प करो.
Nafees, उनका माइक्रोफोन बंद है अभी.
हाँ.
अब हुआ?
Yes, sir, अब ऑन हो गया.
हाँ. चलिए, सबको नमस्ते. मैंने तो काफी काम किया है माइग्रेशन पे भी. 94-95 में ही मैंने फेलोशिप बिल्डर फाउंडेशन का लेके काम किया था और तब से मैं अलग अलग तरह से लिख पढ़ रहा हूँ. पढ़ाई तो कर ही रहा हूँ, लिख भी रहा हूँ. लेकिन जिस तरह से संजय के या देशकाल के नोट में चीजें हैं उस तरह से मैंने कभी नहीं सोचा था कि वो, क्योंकि अभी पहली बार मुझे लगता है कि मैं तो 95 से लिख रहा हूँ या और उसके पहले से भी लिखने वाले लोग हैं, लेकिन ये प्रॉब्लम कितनी बड़ी है और किस लेवल की है और इसमें किस तरह की मुश्किलें जुड़ी हुई हैं इसका अंदाजा पहली बार अभी हुआ. और सरकार और बाकी चीज़ों का हाल ये था कि मुझे लगता है कि लॉकडाउन बोलते हुए हमारे प्रधानमंत्री को अंदाज़ा नहीं था कि मुल्क में कितने माइग्रेंट हैं और उनकी क्या मुश्किलें हैं या उनको क्या मुश्किलें होंगी. वो एक दफ़े भी ध्यान नहीं दिया गया. वो ध्यान तब आया जब टीवी चैनलों ने सड़क पे या रेल लाइन पे मरे हुए मजदूरों की एक खबर देनी शुरू कर दी. उसके पहले वो भी खबर नहीं दे रहे थे और अखबारों में भी खबरें बहुत दब छुप के आ रही थी. लोग दिखाई दे रहे थे सड़कों पे और काफ़ी एनजीओ और काफ़ी लोग, भले लोग भी सड़कों पे उनको मदद कर रहे थे. पुलिस पीट रही थी, कहीं पुलिस मदद कर रही थी, लेकिन जो समस्या शुरू हुई और जिस स्केल पे शुरू हुई उसका अंदाज़ा मुझे लगता है किसी को नहीं था. तो अभी जब हम बात कर रहे हैं तो अच्छे वक्त में मैं कहूँगा कि माइग्रेंट समस्या के लिए एक अच्छा वक्त है जिसमें सबको दिखाई दे गया है कि क्या मुश्किल है और क्या क्या इसको संभालना कितना बड़ा काम है. ये बहुत छोटा काम नहीं है कि 5 किलो अनाज दे दिया और 500 रुपये का रिलीफ पहुंचा दिया तो उतने से ये समस्या सुलझ जाएगी. तब भी ये है कि कहीं से तो शुरुआत करनी होगी और वो शुरुआत हमारे जैसे ग्रुप अगर कर रहे हैं वो भी उसका स्वागत है. और इस किस्म की पहल सरकार की तरफ से भी अभी अचानक घोषणा हुई, हालांकि उस घोषणा में 2-3 बातें ऐसी थीं जिससे मुझे लगा कि प्रधानमंत्री बिहार चुनाव को टारगेट कर रहे हैं, जिसमें छठी मैया का याद आना, अब किसी गुजराती प्रधानमंत्री को छठ की याद आए तो जरूर बिहार चुनाव उसमें एक पॉइंट है. और ये नवंबर तक बढ़ाना भी कहीं ना कहीं उसमें दिवाली तक कहते उसकी जगह उन्होंने बजाता छठ तक बढ़ाने का अनाउंस किया. तो वो सब पॉइंट है, उनको मैं नहीं छूना चाहूँगा. और वो लागू कैसे हो रहे हैं नहीं हो रहे हैं ये सरकार की भी चिंता है और एनजीओ भी उसमें दखल दे सकते हैं. और मुझे लग रहा है कि कई राज्यों ने, खासतौर से छत्तीसगढ़ या बिहार भी मैं उसमें गिनता हूँ, उन्होंने राशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का कामकाज काफ़ी व्यवस्थित कर दिया है. और जितनी पॉलिटिकल कॉन्शसनेस है अगर गड़बड़ कहीं होती है तो लोग उसका विरोध करना शुरू करते हैं और विरोध हुआ है तो फिर वो चीज़ें सुधरी हैं. क्योंकि अभी तक कम से कम नीतीश कुमार सरकार में इतनी ईमानदारी है कि इस तरह की आवाज़ को दबाने की कोशिश बहुत बहुत ढंग से मैनेज करते हैं चीज़ों को, लेकिन इन चीज़ों को दबाने की कोशिश अभी तक नहीं हुई है. तो आपको अगर शिकायत आती है कि राशन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन में गड़बड़ हुई है या किसी और किस्म की गड़बड़ हो रही है तो उस पर ध्यान दिया जा रहा है। उत्तर प्रदेश में तकलीफ ज़्यादा है, उत्तर प्रदेश में इस मामले में ज़्यादा मोटी बुद्धि मैं कहूँगा प्रशासन का है कि उसको इन चीज़ों के बारे में सेंसिटिविटी अभी नहीं आई है। हालांकि अनाउंसमेंट वहाँ भी काफ़ी बड़े बड़े हुए हैं, अभी पिछले दिनों ही प्रधानमंत्री ने जाके वहाँ माइग्रेंट्स को घर में काम देने का ही काफ़ी बड़ा प्रोग्राम शुरू कराया। लेकिन जो भी प्रोग्राम शुरू कराया जा रहा है, कुल मिला के 50,000 करोड़ की रकम बताई जा रही है उस योजना में लगाने की सरकार की इच्छा, और मनरेगा का बजट बढ़ाने की, दो तरह से बड़ा फंड उसके लिए आया है। लेकिन जितनी बड़ी समस्या है उसमें अगर ये 80-90 हजार करोड़ या 1 लाख करोड़ रुपए लगाए जाते हैं तो वो समस्या सुलझनी नहीं है, क्योंकि मेरे हिसाब से माइग्रेंट्स की गिनती कहीं भी 20 करोड़ से ऊपर है और 10-11 करोड़ तो बहुत ही मुश्किल हालत वाले लोग हैं जो रोज कमाओ खाओ वाले हालत में है, तो उनके लिए क्या चीज़ें होंगी ये कहना मुश्किल है। एक, जब माइग्रेंट जा रहे थे तो अचानक संघ के कई लोगों की तरफ से और सरकारों की तरफ से, खासतौर से बिहार और यूपी सरकार की तरफ से ये आया कि हम उनको अपने घर पे ही नौकरी देंगे और गांवों को फिर नए सिरे से डेवलपमेंट के मैप पर ले आना पड़ेगा जिससे मजदूर वहां रुकें और वहीं उनको काम मिले और उनका सामान बिके। ये अपने आप में बहुत अच्छी सोच है कि गांवों में इस किस्म के कामकाज शुरू हों, इस तरह का उत्पादन शुरू हो, इस किस्म के खपत शुरू हो, और अगर उत्पादन अपने गांव से ज़्यादा होता है तो उसके डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन का नेटवर्क खड़ा किया जाए। ये करना बहुत बड़ा काम है और ये बहुत बड़ा काम सरकारों के लिए तो बड़ा है ही, मैं कहूँगा सारे मुल्क के लिए भी बड़ा है, क्योंकि डेवलपमेंट का जो लाइन अभी चल रहा है उसमें इस किस्म का काउंटर डेवलपमेंट, एक अलग तरह से चीज़ों को ले जाना काउंटर डेवलपमेंट माना जाएगा। जैसे मनरेगा जब शुरू हुआ तो आपको याद होगा अच्छी तरह कि काफी सारे लोगों ने कहा कि इससे तो रिवर्स माइग्रेशन शुरू होगा और डेवलपमेंट का सारा काम रुक जाएगा, तो डेवलपमेंट का अभी जो लाइन है उसमें ये मुश्किल है। लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि देशकाल जैसे एनजीओ या और इस किस्म के और भी जो ग्रुप हैं वो ये काम कर सकते हैं, खास तौर से कुछ गांवों को एडॉप्ट करके, और बहुत बड़ी संख्या ना हो तो जितने अपने साधन हो, जितने अपने लोग हो, उस हिसाब से हम ये सोचें कि 10-20 गांव एडॉप्ट करें और फिर ये कोशिश करें कि उन गांवों में क्या पैदा हो सकता है और जो मजदूर वापस लौटे हैं उनका स्किल क्या है, उन स्किल्स से क्या होगा। माइग्रेशन का एक जो मेरी स्टडी थी उसमें ये बहुत बात साफ सामने आती है कि जब माइग्रेंट्स की कमाई गाँव में आती है तो छोटे छोटे धंधे गाँव में लोगों ने शुरू कर दिए, दवा की बिक्री काफी होने लगी, हर गांव में 1-2 दवा की दुकान खुल गई, किराना दुकानें तो पहले भी थी लेकिन ज्यादा बड़ी संख्या में खुली, फर्टिलाइजर बिकने लगा, डीजल बिकने लगा गांव-गांव में, सब्जी फल दूध का कलेक्शन होने लगा, तो उस किस्म की चीजें तो हुई हैं। और अभी भी अगर इतने हैंड आए हैं जिनमें से काफी सारे लोग कष्ट करके आए हैं और एक तरह से ये तय करके आए हैं कि अब गाँव में ही रहेंगे नहीं आएंगे, तो वो कुछ ना कुछ करेंगे। और बिहार के लिए मैं खास तौर से कह सकता हूँ कि बिहार में जिस किस्म की बिजली की उपलब्धता बढ़ी है गाँव में, हर गाँव में 20-22 घंटे बिजली बड़े आराम से आजकल रहती है बिहार, तो वहाँ फिर ये छोटे छोटे काम करने की शुरुआत हो सकती है और लोग करेंगे भी, छोटे इन्वेस्टमेंट के बेसिस पे छोटा छोटा कोई बिल्डिंग का कारोबार, कोई मशीन ठीक करने का कारोबार, कोई टीवी रेडियो ठीक करने का कारोबार, कहीं बिजली का कोई दुकान, दवा की दुकानों में सुधार, हेल्थ के लिए बाकी चीजें, पानी का सप्लाई बिहार में एक बड़ा काम इसकी अचानक हो गया है। फिर हमने देखा था कि प्राइवेट स्कूल लगभग हर गांव में, जहां सरकारी स्कूल अच्छा है वहां भी प्राइवेट स्कूल शुरू हो गया, लेकिन प्राइवेट टीचिंग बड़े पैमाने पे शुरू हुई थी। आजकल अब ये सुन रहे हैं, पता नहीं असलियत अभी क्या है, कि मजदूरों के पैसे नहीं आने के बाद से प्राइवेट स्कूल का कारोबार काफी हद तक ठप हो गया है। तो ये चीजें क्या शेप लेंगी और कैसे ले सकती हैं और उसमें हम किस किस्म की मदद कर सकते हैं, ये देशकाल और इस तरह के एनजीओ सोच सकते हैं। पूरे बिहार के स्तर पे ना हो, पूरे यूपी के स्तर पे ना हो, मुल्क के स्तर पे ना हो, लेकिन एक ब्लॉक के लेवल पे 5 पंचायत, 4 पंचायत, 10 पंचायत, इस किस्म के इलाके चुन के हम एक सर्वे करें कि जो मजदूर आए हैं वो क्या स्किल वाले हैं, क्या जरूरत यहाँ है और क्या यहाँ साधन उपलब्ध है। साधन मैं दो एडिशन में मानता हूँ कि अभी तक जो था उससे हो गया। एक तो वर्किंग हैंड काफी वापस आ गए हैं, कट्टे कट्टे लोग जो अब तक गांव में खाली बूढ़े और बीमार और बच्चे और औरतें इस किस्म की बची हुई थी, उनकी जगह काम करने वाले लोग लौट आए हैं। और दूसरा, सड़क का और बिजली का कनेक्शन काफी बढ़िया हुआ है। तो इन साधनों के इस्तेमाल से क्या किया जा सकता है, इसका एक छोटा सर्वे जल्दी करके एक तो इमीडिएट देखें कि जो साधन सरकार बता रही है वो लोगों को मिल रहा है कि नहीं मिल रहा था, उसको साथ जोड़ सकते हैं इसके। लेकिन एक प्लानिंग हम ये कर सकते हैं कि ये सर्वे करें और इन चीजों को देखें और फिर उसमें क्या पूंजी लगेगी, क्या स्किल लगेगा, वो कैसे मुहैया कराया जा सकता है, वो हम करा सकते हैं, वो सरकार को सुझाव दे सकते हैं, वो लोकल MLA MP को पकड़ के करा सकते हैं क्योंकि उनके पास भी फंड आजकल रहता है। तो अगर ढंग से इस किस्म की शुरुआत होगी, 5-10 पंचायतों से भी, मुझे लगता है कि 5 पंचायतों से भी शुरुआत अगर ठीक हो तो उस काम को फैलने में देरी नहीं लगेगी। क्योंकि काफी माइग्रेंट, वो सब कोई बंद अकल नहीं है लोग और न कोई जानवर है, वो सब होशियार लोग हैं, हटे कटे लोग हैं, शरीर से बुद्धि से सब तरह से वो स्वस्थ लोग हैं। तो वो भी नजर चारों ओर दौड़ा रहे हैं कि उनको कहाँ से किस किस्म का काम मिलेगा। तो अगर काम का कोई मॉडल कहीं डेवलप होता है तो तुरंत उनकी तरफ से भी काफी कुछ हो सकता है। अभी अचानक मैं देख रहा हूँ कि कई ग्रुप और कई लोग खेती नए तरह से करने कराने की, खासतौर से फर्टिलाइजर और केमिकल फ्री और जो जिसको आजकल बोल रहे हैं, क्या बोल रहे हैं उस सब्जी और फल को, इसमें किसी किस्म का केमिकल नहीं पड़ा हुआ है, उस किस्म की खेती कराने की कोशिश भी काफी सारी शुरू हो रही है। तो अगर ये श्रम शक्ति रही, अगर ये बिजली और उसके पानी की उपलब्धता रही, अगर सड़कों से सामान को निकालने की और ले आने की सुविधा रही, तो मुझे लगता है कि ये नई चीजें हैं जिनके बेसिस पे पहल की जा सकती है। और ये पहल अगर सफल हुई तो इस चीज को नकल होने में इसका और इसके विस्तार में कोई ज्यादा वक्त नहीं लगेगा। तो हम सब लोग अपना साधन थोड़ा पहले जज करें और फिर उस बेसिस पे इस काम की शुरुआत करें। सर्वे का काम शुरू कर सकते हैं, जानकारियां जुटाने का कर सकते हैं, और उसी के साथ साथ ये कि जो सरकारी योजनाएं हैं उसमें अभी किस किस्म की मदद हो सकती है और कहाँ बॉटलनेक है, वो बॉटलनेक कैसे दूर होगा, अधिकारियों से मिलके, पॉलिटिशियनों से मिलके उसको दूर कराने की कोशिश करें। तो मुझे तो ये दो काम सूझ रहा है, और बाकी लोगों बोलें तो फिर उस पर अपनी राय।
थैंक यू अरविंद जी, शुक्रिया। आई थिंक इसमें संजय जी के लिए काफ़ी पॉइंट्स हैं एंड होमवर्क है हम सब लोगों के लिए कि इसमें किस प्रकार से एक पायलट प्रोजेक्ट के लिए हम लोग कोशिश कर सकते हैं और रिसोर्सेज को कहाँ से मुहैया कराया जा सकता है। आई थिंक फ्रॉम एन एक्शन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दैट इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एरिया विच इज अ टास्क अहेड। May I then now move on to request my old friend, Professor Shakti Kumar, who is the chairperson at the Center for Economic Studies and Planning at School of Social Studies, JNU. And Shakti and I go back to almost like 30 years. We studied together. We were hostel mates and college mates in JNU. So, Shakti, thank you for agreeing to join us on a short notice. May I request you to throw some light on your own perspective? And I know that aap UP ke bare mein bhi kaafi likhte padhte rahe hain. So, can we just try and have some balance of the UP perspective also? How you see the difference in the situation? Can we look at some kind of a model in Eastern UP? Because Eastern UP also happens to be a high out migration area in the districts in Eastern UP. So can we pick up some comparative project interventions also there? And what are some of the specifics that we could look into in the light of what Sanjay ji and Dr. Praveen Sinha and our... Hello?
Hello?
Shakti?
Namaskar, bhai sahab.
Namaste.
Kaise hai?
Bas badhiya, sab achhe hai.
Good. Good afternoon, everybody. Sanjay ji, Parveen ji, and other dignitaries who are participating here. So Arvind Mohan ji, Kamal ji, and Arvind Mishra ji. We are talking about the labor migrant. On 1st of June, this year itself, one article was published in the Hindustan, and it was written by myself itself. Hello?
Yes, yes, Shakti.
And the title of the article was Mazdooron ki bina arthvyavastha kaise sambhalenge rajya. 1 June Hindustan mein publish hua tha, pure journal. I had written in this paper why the migrant laborer came on the road. मैंने इसमें लिखा है, सवाल यह है कि मजदूर आखिर क्यों सड़क पर आए। पहला कारण तो यह है कि राज्य सरकारों ने उसकी क्रय शक्ति पर ध्यान नहीं दिया। दूसरा कारण इसमें है राजनीति। जिस राज्य मजदूर रह रहे थे वहां शायद ये सोच रहे होंगे कि वो उनके समर्थक नहीं है। तीसरा कारण यह हो सकता है कि जिस राज्य में सदियों से वो रह रहे थे वहां उन्होंने जमीन खरीद लिया, मकान भी बना लिया, आय में हिस्सा भी लेने लगे, इसलिए लोकल जो वहां के होंगे पीपुल वे इनका विरोध कर रहे थे। और ये जो कोरोना काल आया, इस काल में उन लोगों को ऐसा अवसर मिला कि उन लोगों को वहां से भगा। ये तीन कारण को मैंने इसमें दर्शाया था। और इसमें यह भी लिखा था कि मजदूरों के पलायन से नुकसान उन राज्यों का भी है जहां से वे निकल आए, क्योंकि वहां कई काम करने वालों की कमी पड़ जाए। नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द नंबर ऑफ द लेबर माइग्रेंट। सेंसस 2011 सेज दैट इंटरनल माइग्रेंट्स आर ऑलमोस्ट 450 मिलियंस. That is 37% of total population, and 88% are intra-state and 12% are interstate. The question arising, why only this labor migrant came on the road? Why the government is thinking for giving just 500 rupees or 100 rupees or 5000 rupees? Some states are giving 500, major of the states are giving 1000, Delhi government gave 5000. Now question arising, what is the basic reason of this migrant labor who came on the road? I think it is the poverty, and there are number of the reason of the poverty. They are thinking that they are poor, they are unable to sustain, so they came on the road. I am asking the question here, why we are thinking only on the poverty line? We should think their dignity line. We should think their employment line. We should think their empowerment line. And we should ultimately think about the basic line. So these are the five lines of the points to be thought over. So 8 basic points to decide the basic lines should be drinking water, availability of drinking water, education, energy, food, healthcare, housing, sanitation, and social security. Article 22 of Human Rights says that every member of the society has right to social security. But social security is being provided to those laborers who are engaged only in the formal sector. So particularly in the case of the Bihar, I would like to share that commission who will register the name and address or even the bank mobile Aadhaar number, that is known as a Jam Triti. जान ट्रीटी इज रिलेटेड विथ जैसे जनधन अकाउंट एज स्टैंड फॉर आधार नंबर एंड एम स्टैंड फॉर मोबाइल नंबर. सो जान ट्रीटी शुड बी रिकॉर्डेड इन द लेबर कमीशन and that would be helpful for counting, not only counting but providing the employability in the other state also. So that labor commission should be given the charge to send the labor in the other state to earn, and salary should be given like a formal sector. So just giving a 500 or 1000 or 5000 is not the solution. So whatever the problem come in the In any economy, these are the poor classes, and especially those are the like the migrant labor. They are the sufferer. So I would like to suggest that in Bihar there should be the labor commission who will be responsible for sending the labor to the other states, and all records should be kept by them. And second point, would like to suggest. There should be livelihood diversification. There should be livelihood diversification. So through the livelihood diversification, their purchasing power can be increased. So that will help for these laborers to be the self-reliant. Unless and yet they become the self-reliant, the problems like a COVID will put them again and again on the road. So I am stopping here, and would like to listen to other people. Thank you, Nikhil, for giving me chance. Thank you, Sanjay ji.
Thank you. Thank you, Shakti, for pointing out some of these things on the whole issue of bringing the line of dignity, empowerment. And Dr. Sinha also mentioned initially how these people were not treated with dignity even within their own communities. There is also an area that you have pointed out about how to link the data with the State Labor Commission, and it is now an urgent task which we could take it up in case we decide to do a kind of a potential pilot, how to do it for the 5 to 10 or 15 GPs in Bihar, and work closely with the Labor Commission to ensure that it is the whole database is linked with JAM and the salaries or their wages are credited. That yeah. brings me to another issue of the psychological aspects. Where you touched upon the whole issues of dignity and empowerment and how they were treated as outsiders, as Dr. Sinha mentioned. We have in our midst Professor Arvind Mishra, who is a seasoned psychologist and has worked closely at the interface of psychology, human development, and labor issues. Professor Arvind Mishra is a professor at the Zakir Hussain Center for Education in the School of Social Sciences at Jawaharlal Nehru University. I would request, in fact, the other day I was reading about this whole idea of embeddedness, and where do they find? They seem to be dislocated from Maharashtra, and their own people are not ready to accept them because they may be the carriers of corona. Thus, beyond that, then do they have the skills? Because they may be having the certificates, what Dr. Sinha said. I think most of us here are from Bihar, and quite of us, we may be having our certificates, but the degrees, but we may not be having the skill certification to do a particular job for either self-entrepreneurship or in an industry. Over to you, Professor Mishra, and how we could take out this discussion forward. And then we'll go on to the next panelist. Welcome. You will have to unmute yourself. Unmute your speaker.
Yeah. Hello. Yeah. Namaskar.
Namaskar.
Can you hear me?
Very much. Thank you.
मैंने सब लोगों को सुना भी, और इसमें सबसे कम क्वालिफाइड इस इशू पे बोलने वाला मैं ही हूँ, क्योंकि मैंने कभी माइग्रेशन के साथ कोई काम नहीं किया, क्योंकि हमारा सब्जेक्ट जो है वो थोड़ा ये भटकता रहता है, और जिसको कह सकते हैं कि वो हवा हवाई जो मानसिक धरातल पे है, निखिल जी ने कहा भी कि साइकोलॉजिकल एस्पेक्ट्स, तो कुछ जो हम लोग सुनते रहते हैं टीवी के न्यूज से या लोगों से बात करके, उसी बेसिस पे मैं कह रहा हूँ कि एक तो अगर साइकोलॉजी की बात आप कहें तो ह्यूमन की कोई एक साइकोलॉजी निश्चित नहीं होती है। साइकोलॉजी जो है जो एक्सटर्नल एनवायरनमेंट जितना चेंज करता है उसके हिसाब से शेप भी होती है। और अभी एक जो टर्म बहुत यूज होता है, मैं भी कभी कभी यूज करता हूँ, नव उदारवाद, न्यू लिबरलिज्म, वो बड़े शहर से छोटे गांव तक के लोगों को प्रभावित किया, उसको प्रभावित किया है। अब रिवर्स माइग्रेशन में ये एक मेरे ख्याल से स्टम्बलिंग ब्लॉक है कि वो जो न्यू लिबरलिज्म का चकाचौंध है, वो चकाचौंध ही है, वो एक तरह से है, लेकिन है वो भी, और लोगों को लगता है कि कुछ हमें मिलेगा इतनी तकलीफ के बाद भी, क्योंकि मजदूरों की जिंदगी अगर शहर में देखें कोई अच्छी तो नहीं होती है, लेकिन उसके बावजूद रहते तो वहीं पे हैं वो। और अगर आप देखें उन लोगों से बात करें तो बहुत लोग ये कहते तकलीफ है, लेकिन एक सेंटिमेंट में गांव आ भी गए एकाएक, हो सकता है कि और लोग आ रहे थे वो भी आ गए, ये भी बात है कि लॉकडाउन हो गया था उनके लिए कुछ वहां था नहीं, सिक्योरिटी सिस्टम नहीं था, लेकिन गांव लौटने के बाद मेरी जितनी बात हुई बहुत सीमित है, सही नहीं भी हो सकता है, वो लोग फिर से लौटना चाहते हैं। जैसे मुझे पता लगा कि मेरे गांव के आसपास के कुछ लोग जो महाराष्ट्र से लौटे, महाराष्ट्र तो नहीं गए लेकिन वो बोकारो और धनबाद अपने किसी जान पहचान के लोगों के साथ वहां चले गए काम करने के लिए। तो एक जो आप साइकोलॉजी की बात कहते हैं, तो वो जो हमारे जो जो ब्रॉडर स्ट्रक्चर है न्यू लिबरलिज्म का, मार्केट है, टेलीविजन है, एडवर्टीजमेंट है, व्हाट्सएप के थ्रू वो सब जो उनका दिमाग जो इन्फ्लुएंस हो रहा है बार बार, और एक बार बार लोग कहते हैं कि देहात में रखा क्या है और हमारे बच्चे क्या पढ़ेंगे यहाँ पे, और ये जबकि शहर में ऐसा नहीं कि उनको पढ़ने की बहुत अच्छी सुविधा मिलती है, और हम लोग ये देखते भी हैं कि उस तबके के लोगों के बच्चों के गवर्नमेंट स्कूल छोड़ के कुछ कोई भी चीज नहीं है, लेकिन तब भी उनको लगता है कि गाँव में कुछ नहीं रखा हुआ है। तो अगर मेंटल लेवल पे फाइट करना है हमें, तो जैसा अरविंद मोहन जी ने भी कहा कि पूरे स्टेट लेवल पे तो एक्सपेरिमेंट करना बड़ा मुश्किल होता है, लेकिन अगर कोई ग्रुप देशकाल हो या देशकाल की जान पहचान किसी ग्रुप से है जो वहां पे एक्टिव हो, और ये देखें हम लोग तो दिल्ली में बैठ के ही ये बात कर रहे हैं, एक तरह का अनुमान है ये हम लोगों का, लेकिन जो लोग जिनके बारे में बात हम कर रहे हैं उनके मन में क्या हो रहा है, वो कैसे सोच रहे हैं, और कोई सिस्टमेटिक हमारे पास थिंकिंग नहीं है उसके, कि कोई डेटा ही नहीं है, एनिकडोटल डेटा है, कुछ सुन लिया एक दो लोगों से और कुछ अपने अनुमान के बेसिस पे हम कर रहे हैं। और सोशल साइंस में बहुत बार हम लोग देखते हैं कि हम लोग जो बैठ के सोचते हैं जिसको टॉप डाउन अप्रोच करते हैं, ग्राउंड लेवल पे उस तरह से लोग रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं करते हैं, कभी कभी ठीक उल्टा रिस्पॉन्ड भी करते हैं। अब जो एंटी ग्लोबलाइजेशन की बात आपने कहा या एंटी डेवलपमेंट की बात आप लोगों ने कहा, कि पता नहीं हद तक ये होगा, क्योंकि मैं देखता हूं कि गांव में, और आप लोग मुझे करेक्ट करेंगे अगर गलत है, कि नेगेटिविटी बहुत ज्यादा अब है। मतलब मैं अपने गांव में जाता हूं तो जाता हूं रिलैक्स करने के मूड में, लेकिन कुछ समय के बाद लोग जो है शिकवे शिकायत बहुत ज्यादा करते हैं, एक दूसरे की शिकायत करते हैं, जबकि वो स्थिति है जबकि बहुत कम लोग गाँव में है, जवान लोग सब बाहर हैं, कम लोग बचे हुए हैं, उसके बावजूद जो है अब मैं वहां पे कोई पॉजिटिविटी उतना नहीं देखता हूँ कोई कुछ करने के लिए, और अगर कोई कुछ कर भी रहा है तो उसके बारे में कोई ना कोई कहानी मिल जाती है, उसने कैसे बेमानी करके ये किया, उसने किसको ठगा, उसने किसको ठगा। अब पहले जब मैं गाँव में रहता था, हो सकता है कि उस समय हम लोग बहुत सजग नहीं थे, शायद ऐसी चीजें उस समय भी होती होगी, लेकिन मेरी मेरी स्मृति में वो बातें नहीं थी। जो बचपन का मेरा गांव था वो वहाँ संबंध मधुर थे, वहाँ पे पॉजिटिविटी थी, वहाँ पे भाईचारा था, वो मुझे अभी नहीं दिखता है। और जब तक अगर वो नहीं सिचुएशन होगा तो रिवर्स माइग्रेशन को लिवरेज करना कि लोग आ गए हैं, मुझे लगता है कि एक तरह से ये डिफीटेड मेंटेलिटी के साथ आए हैं कि वहां से ये बिहार से भी जो लोग गए थे, और बहुत लोग ऐसे होंगे जो कि बीए और एमए करके गए होंगे, एक तो ऑलरेडी डिमोरलाइज्ड हैं कि उनके बीए एमए का कोई काम नहीं है, और दिल्ली और बॉम्बे और गुजरात में जहां भी जा रहे हैं वो लेबर ही बन के रह रहे हैं, जहां पे उनको कोई सम्मान नहीं मिल रहा है। लेकिन एक ये मेंटेलिटी है कि अपने गांव में वो काम करेंगे तो लोग हंसेंगे, तो बाहर करो कोई देखेगा नहीं, और कुछ तो पैसा मिल ही जाता है और फिर वो अपनी एक जिंदगी चलाते हैं और कभी कभी अपने गांव आते हैं। अब गांव आके उनको लग रहा है कि मैं वहां गया था गांव छोड़ के और कुछ अच्छी ही बात करता था कि ये कर रहे हैं ये कर रहे हैं ये कर रहे हैं, अब लौट आए, ठीक है उसमें उनका कोई दोष नहीं है, ये तो पेंडेमिक है, लेकिन उनके पास कोई एक जो कहते हैं नी जर्क रिएक्शन कि तत्काल कुछ एक रिएक्ट तो कर रहे हैं कि वो ठीक नहीं है, यहीं पे करेंगे वो करेंगे, लेकिन वो बहुत आसान चीज नहीं है। जबकि सरकार का सहयोग नहीं मिले और लोगों का सहयोग नहीं मिले, अकेला कोई कौन क्या कर लेगा। और जो मैंने कहा कि वहां पे नेगेटिविटी इतना है, एक दूसरे के लिए सस्पिशन इतना में है, तो जब तक एक जिसको साइनर्जी कहते हैं ना कि कोई एक ग्रुप तो बिना थोड़ा एक्सटर्नल इंटरवेंशन चाहिए, केवल आप उनके इनिशिएटिव पे छोड़ देंगे तो कुछ नहीं होगा। एक एक्सटर्नल इंटरवेंशन, एक्सटर्नल जिनकी थोड़ी क्रेडिबिलिटी हो, एक क्रेडिबिलिटी डेफिसिट भी बहुत बड़ा इशू है वहां पे। कोई भी करने आता है तो मैं नैरेटिव हमेशा ये सुनता हूँ वो इसमें कितना बेमानी कर रहा है या उसके पीछे उसका असली मकसद क्या है, ये दिखाने के लिए ये कर रहा है, असली मकसद क्या है। उनके पास तमाम इतनी कहानी है कि किसी पे विश्वास वो कर नहीं पाते हैं, और इसीलिए कोई साइनर्जी डेवलप नहीं होती है और कोई अच्छा काम बहुत हो नहीं पाता है। मैंने अपने गाँव के आसपास जो देखे, पहले भी कुछ छोटे मोटे प्रोजेक्ट स्टार्ट हुआ, एक फैनफेयर से स्टार्ट हुआ, कुछ दिन चला भी लेकिन फिर बंद हो गया। तो इस माहौल में हमें लगता है कि मैं मतलब पेसिमिस्टिक नोट पे नहीं छोड़ना चाहता हूँ, मैं कहूँगा कि एक छोटे लेवल पे देश काल वहाँ के किसी भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के टच में रह के जो वहाँ पे काम कर रहे हैं, कुछ तो एक ग्राउंड लेवल का इन्फॉर्मेशन लें कि लोग क्या सोच रहे हैं, कैसे सोच रहे हैं, और जो बात हम सुझा रहे हैं वो उनके सामने भी रखें कि ऐसी बात लोग सोच रहे हैं, आपको क्या लगता है कि ये संभव है, क्योंकि हम यहाँ से टॉप डाउन अप्रोच से ड्रॉप करें कोई चीज और उसको वो रिजेक्ट कर दे तो उसका क्या मतलब है, क्योंकि फाइनली दे आर द एक्टर, अनलेस दे आर कन्विंस्ड व्हाट इज गुड फॉर देम, आई थिंक आवर सजेशन विल नॉट बी ऑफ एनी हेल्प। अभी मैं इतना ही कहूँगा, थोड़ा नेगेटिव है लेकिन दिस इज व्हाट आई थिंक केम टू माई माइंड एंड आई वॉन्टेड टू शेयर विद यू। थैंक यू।
Thank you, Professor Mishra. I think this mental dilemma, the mental issues will always continue to govern many of our social actions, behaviors, and livelihood patterns. Since most of us are from Bihar, I take this opportunity. I'm reminded of two local sayings there, is that this whole definition of the urge of going to the cities to settle, regardless of what in whatever conditions you stay there. So I had heard it in my villages and in Patna and around there, that it says that ki padhve to padhao na to sahar mein basao. So the idea is ki just put somebody there in the city and the guy will prosper or the girl will prosper. On the other hand, I have come across it could be a hearsay. But somebody told me that once Dr. Rajendra Prasad, our first president, he went back to some village in Bihar, and he was in a meeting, and there was an old lady who asked him, and in a couplet form it is said that ki dekhe mein kuch dubar patar, khaye piye ke to dukh nahi ke. It was in Bhojpuri. And he responded very immediately because he came from a Bhojpuri speaking area. And he said that supposedly, I mean, I wasn't there. So I've heard it from my aunt that he said that sab sukhwa Delhi nagri mein bhojan chhajan basab bharpur sabse badka dhukwa bari rauwa login se bani badi dur. So touching two core dimensions of this psychology, human psychology, that you may be at the best of the achievements in life, but when you are away from your own centers, then what are the mental turmoils that you go through? And yet at the same time, the allure of the urban centers that keeps you pulling there. That takes me to one of the last part, something that we need to understand is that's where the money is. One of the biggest set of partners is the corporates. I have with us another person who comes from a high out migration district, Mr. Kamal Kumar Singh. Kamalji, please switch on your video. Thank you. So Kamalji is, he has been a director with several international private sector corporates, ranging from Emerson, Asia Brown and Barbary, Danfoss, and in the manufacturing sector, right from the north, from North India. He's an engineering by graduate and has been responsible for some of laying down the foundations of the Panipat refinery, one of his key achievements that I know of. And he's been in the energy sector. May I request you that, you know, how do you see, particularly 2 days back, I read about this news item that of the 10 special trains that are going from Bhagalpur to Bombay, 7 are fully booked now and the migrants are returning back to their destination areas. Over to you, Kamalji, for your responses. Thank you for joining.
Yeah, good evening, Nikhil, and good evening to all of participants in this webinar and Google Meet. And it's a pleasure for me to attend this. Thanks for the invitation to Nikhil and Sanjay ji. I've heard every speaker very intently, and all of them gave a very, very relevant points based on their experience and what they have done in the past in this, in particular, this specialized field called labor. Though I don't have any experience on labor, but from the business perspective, I can give a couple of points. How to mitigate the situation in the medium term and the long term. Short term, many things have been announced by government of India or respective state governments. So I don't want to touch upon that. Those short term things are very mixed in nature, political, come immediate relief. So that's a big topic to I don't want to touch upon. From the business point of view, I want to touch upon two or three aspects. As per the government of India, company rule, each company has got an obligation to spend the money in CS under CSR. And there's some threshold of the turnover and a profit is there. I'm sure a couple of you must be knowing those threshold, how much profit and how, and there's a window of 2 years or 3 years there is open, left open to the corporate to spend the money. So in this context, the affected states like Bihar in particular, if all of us are from Bihar, so let's talk about Bihar. The Bihar government can come out with the some kind of a communication package with those top 50 corporates who have been employing the people from Bihar. Some kind of a thumb rule, some data can be arrived within a week, 10 days from various districts. Okay, how many people are work for which location? The way you gave the example, okay, some trains have left Bhagalpur for Bombay. So let's contact big corporates in Bombay, let's say Tata, Birla's, or XYZ, and let's have a communication with those CEO or owner of the company, okay, how to spend a portion or of the money of CSR to mitigate the medium-term hardship what people are suffering after coming back from respective job locations. So that's one point I would like to, I am sure that if the state government wants to do that with the proper intention, with the proper planning, if they reach out to 50 corporates, I'm sure 15 corporates out of 50 will venture out because they know how many people, what kind of people they have employed from Bihar through various sources they can find out, and they can take a step forward to help Bihar migrants who have come back. Second point I want to make from business perspective, again, onus lies on the how Bihar government is going to plan out properly to and wants sincerely to address the problem to the laborers or the workers who have come back from respective locations. What they should do, again, I will say they should invite top 20 companies like Tata's, L&T, especially here, labor-intensive industry or manufacturing industry to Patna. Let the Bihar government host them, those top 20 companies, representative of those top 20 companies. Let all the district magistrates of the Bihar come to that meeting. And let the person who is hosting the meeting, the Bihar government, let them ask those top 20 corporates, okay, what kind of, when you are going to reopen your business under Unlock 2.0, Unlock 3.0, or Unlock 4.0, what kind of a people hiring pattern will happen in your organization. So if those kind of a broad data is obtained in that meeting, then the respective district magistrate can go back to their respective district and communicate to the various people in the district through a block development officer or whatever the medium the district magistrate wants to choose. So with that, the communication comes down to the affected people and they can have some kind of confidence. Yes, things are improving. Things are going to improve after 4 months, 6 months down the line. This is the second point. Third point, if some database has to be obtained, that will not be 100% correct. But again, this Nikhil took an example of Panipat refinery about my one of the experience. Like that, from the large infrastructure projects, Bihar government should identify what are the large infrastructure projects we are being running across the country where they can obtain the data from the labor department of those project site and the project owner and their subcontractor. Okay, what kind of people you had, from where they came from, who are those people? They must be maintaining those subcontractors and contractors and large EPC company must be maintaining the data. They're supposed to maintain the data because of health and safety factor. All the data has to be maintained from the health and safety. So those data can be obtained and keep a track of all those projects. Okay, when the project is going to reopen and going to restart the work, so these people can be sent back to the same projects in the medium term. So these are the quickly three points broadly I have, which can be implemented by the Bihar government if the Deskal takes up the point with the appropriate authority in the government of Bihar. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Kamalji, for your comments. I think, you know, as a practitioner, you have given us some of the leads in terms of how the corporates can be, their CSR funds could be leveraged, and particularly, you know, an actionable plan for the district magistrates to come to get a handle of the real data in terms of the potential hiring few months later, given that the migrants would be yearning back to go back to their destination areas. What Professor Mishra also talked about, that the allure of the neoliberalism or the push factor, somewhere it will make them to go back to the destination areas. Some of the large infrastructure projects, and all this will come when we do a kind of a comprehensive discussion and engagement and mapping of the data. I would like now Dr. Praveen Sinha request his thoughts in terms of conclusions and way forward. Where do we go about it, sir? And what should be the next steps? You know, what should be the homework for Deskal Koti? Sir, your microphone, sir.
I think majority of us are in a training stage, all those who have painted their hair white. So they are in a training stage. Yeah, I think the views that have been expressed by four or five speakers has been excellent, I think. few are specific, and a few others are with regard to developing an ecosystem for the returning migrant. One area that I see is that before we are able to go at the ground level, ground zero level with regard to starting a project, we need to develop a framework that will help us to develop the database that we have been talking about. And that database may not only include what the migrant workers are faced with, but we can take the larger, more comprehensive database, what Mr. Kamal has suggested with regard to companies, where you have not only owners, but those who are occupying a prominent positions. And I can give an example where it works. All of us know Durga Puja time, right? And I have a lot many Bengali friends, and they are so effective in generating resources because they catch Bengalis sitting at the prominent positions in various companies. So, koi 10,000 deta, koi 50,000, koi lakh deta, but collectively they are able to make a lot of funds available for whatever projects they are taking. So I take Kamal's proposal with all sincerity and seriousness. We need to touch upon, you see, in economics, that is the disadvantage of economics. That is the disadvantage of economics, that we over-focus financial issues. And what some of you have highlighted is the psychological issue, is the sociological issues. And that has longer impact, but those impacts are not immediately visible. And we see all these things in our day-to-day life, that you have some issues which are hidden below, but the money takes over because that is more visible and more suppressing. So when we develop a project, I think we look at the ecosystem of migrant workers. So what kind of ecosystem they are facing, they were facing at the place of work, and what are they facing, and their desire to go back. Will that imply that they are going back to the same exploitative situation that they were faced with? And I think these are some of things that we need to take up. One idea also came from Mr. Anand Mohan, is with regard to not enlarging the canvas too much. We have to look at our capacity. And in a functional research area, it is said that if you want to show the result, you keep the sample small, because then the possibility of dilution becomes limited. But yes, then the sample has to be selected in a manner that those are effective representative of the larger population that we are looking at. So I think this is what I will suggest. I will ask both Sanjayji and Nikhilji to incorporate the comments that has been presented, that has been put forth by all these learned speakers. And then we look at the document and we sharpen it and we find a way to either take the approach what Mr. Kamal said, or we touch upon the state government and see whether there are somebody who is willing to provide us some resources at the state level or at the central level. That is where I stop. Insofar international agencies are concerned, with all fairness, let me say, with all fairness, I say the current political scenario of India is not very conducive. And as such, almost everybody is sitting with hands tight behind the back, not in front. So we might be able to get some fund, but not larger fund if we are looking at. And in that context, I think it will be advisable, like I said that before, that it has to be a smaller sample. It has to be either one district, two district, three district. Let's take a smaller one to start with a provision for larger survey at a later time. We can touch upon institutions such as UN coordinator. Nowadays, they have a UN coordinator, which they have their own grouping now. All UN bodies have come together to form a group. And in deciding about which project to take, which not to take, they look at what is their area of allocation. And the allocation is in the background of the Sustainable Development Goal, the SDGs. So whether we can connect our effort with SDG will also help, because that will somehow link with one or other agencies. And like, for example, UNICEF is looking at the education. So education, poverty is some area. ILO is looking at the employment side, employment, poverty, livelihood area. UNIDO is looking at the manufacturing sector, industrial sector. So these are some areas that you can put, and there is no harm in applying that. And what can say? Nahi hai ya paise kam hai, but there is no harm in applying to them and finding whether we can find a way to at least meet face to face. If somebody invites us to meet face to face, almost 70% of the job is done. The remaining 30% is how we talk with the person concerned. I stop here.
Nikhil, are you hearing me?
I can hear you.
Yeah, so let me conclude.
Yes, we can. We have to conclude. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
Over to you, Sanjay.
I mean, no, in fact, really, we are deeply indebted by the panelists and observation and comment made by them. I think so. It is indeed my privilege. All of us are the core traveler, not only for the Discal Society and the work of the Discal Society, but most importantly, which emerged through the discussion. Specific points and the particular questions. The action, immediate action plan. And we believe with these co-travelers, we will take forward this agenda, and to some extent, we as much as possible try our best to move it up forward in the right direction.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for joining us and for sparing your valuable time. We look forward to your continued support and encouragement.